On average, a human adult sighs every 5 minutes. But that's not because we're perpetually exasperated. Sure, there are emotional sighs, but there are also physiological ones. And we actually have to take those extra deep breaths. They're crucial to healthy lung function. But we didn't figure that out until we invented machines to help people breathe. The first tank ventilator, basically a giant box you can put someone into to breathe for them, was invented back in the 1830s, but the most familiar iteration came about in the 1920s. This was the infamous iron lung, a phrase coined by an unknown journalist, and it's mostly associated with the polio epidemics that swept across America and Europe in the early to mid-20th century. They work by applying external negative pressure. Dropping the pressure inside the tank causes a corresponding drop in the patient's lungs. That causes outside air to flow into the lungs, and by increasing the pressure, the air flows back out. It replaces the job of the diaphragm, the muscle that controls airflow. In the case of many polio patients, this muscle would become paralyzed. Sighing was first described, medically speaking, in 1919. By the time they were using the iron lung on polio patients, treatment reports stressed the importance of administering deep breaths interspersed with the regular ones. In fact, one of the device's early test subjects actually requested deep breaths for comfort. As you breathe, tiny fluid-lined sacs in your lungs, called alveoli, will occasionally collapse. It's totally normal, but they can't reinflate under a typical shallow breath because the fluid causes the sides of the sacs to stick together. And when they're collapsed, they can't exchange CO2 for oxygen like they're supposed to, at least not very well. Sighing resets the lungs by re-expanding the alveoli, so in extreme situations, sighing could be the difference between life and death. Extreme situations like needing an iron lung to breathe for you. By the mid-20th century, devices like the iron lung were being phased out in favor of the method we see in modern ventilators. Instead of negative pressure, they directly pump air down the patient's throat. And research suggests sighs can be helpful in certain, though not all, cases of positive pressure ventilation as well. We're also still learning how we sigh, but it seems to be remarkably simple. We now know that the human body senses when we need to sigh by using two kinds of sensors receptors. One detects the amount your lung's volume has collapsed, and the other detects the concentration of oxygen in your blood. Sensing the need to sigh then gets converted into the instructions to actually take a deeper breath. Research has also shown that, at least in rodents, sighing is controlled by tiny clusters of neurons in the brainstem. This is the smallest number of neurons ever linked to such a fundamental behavior, suggesting that sighing really is pretty basic. These neurons instruct the production of two signaling molecules, which tell the lungs to turn a regular breath into a sigh. Scientists are still trying to figure out what causes emotional sighing, but in the meantime, understanding the intricacies of physiological sighs will allow us to help regulate healthy breathing in patients who need it. It could also lead to medication that helps people manage breathing problems brought on by anxiety or stress, as well as neurological disorders. It's a surprisingly fundamental behavior that we're all still trying to understand, but clearly, sighing is about more than just signaling how bored you are. Thanks for watching this episode of SciShow. And don't forget, you probably sighed at least once during this video. If you'd like to help us unravel more bizarre facts about the universe and about ourselves, why not consider supporting us on Patreon? We've got neat perks to say thanks, like fancy facts and an exclusive podcast. If you're interested, check out patreon.com/scishow.